Per- or polyfluoroalkyl substances, or PFAS, have become ubiquitous in our modern lives. First developed by 3M in the 1930s and mass marketed in the 40s and 50s, these synthetic chemicals, also known as perfluorinated chemicals or PFCs, enable the development of nonstick cookware,
well, good thing it's Teflon,
water-repellent clothing, and firefighting foam. Today, there are thousands of these chemicals known by acronyms like PFOS, PFOA, PFNA, and PFHXS. The problem? The chemical bonds that give PFAS their heat, oil, and water-resistant qualities are so resilient they don't break down in the environment or in the human body. It doesn't take long for PFAS to make their way into drinking water and finally the human bloodstream. They've been linked to various health effects, including pregnancy complications and problems related to the liver, lungs, and thyroid. Companies like 3M and DuPont have spent hundreds of millions of dollars settling lawsuits over such health impacts. PFAS are no longer made or in use in the United States, but elevated levels persist in soil samples and drinking water supplies across Pennsylvania, particularly near military facilities where they were used in firefighting foam. That includes the Harrisburg International Airport, which for decades was the site of an Air Force installation. The EPA issued an advisory warning to the public about PFAS, setting a limit of 70 parts per trillion. Although recent research indicates that even much smaller concentrations of the chemical can be dangerous. But because PFAS are considered an emerging contaminant, the EPA does not formally regulate the toxin. Yet. Late last year, Governor Tom Wolf issued an executive order establishing a PFAS action team to identify contaminated drinking water systems and develop a plan to sample more drinking water, limit public exposure, and potentially introduce state-level regulation. It joins several other states in scrutinizing PFAS. A lot will be developing on this issue over the next few years.